Today I want to talk about motherhood. I've been a mom since 2002. I had my first daughter when I was 14 years old, and she got taken away by CPS because I was already in CPS custody, and they felt that I was too young to have a child. And also, I took my daughter to go see my mother, which they said was endangering my child, so they took her. I fought for 2 years, and I lost the case. But I do get, I have open adoption, so I still get to see her when they choose, which sucks. But then I have my second daughter in 2006. Now, when I had her, I had a job, and I was living with my mom, but I still had a job, and my mom rent, and you know what she needed, diapers and formula and everything like that. And when Sierra started growing up, when I would get my paycheck, I would ask her, what do you want to do? That was the first thing I asked, of course I did the math and I subtracted, the rent bill, okay, how much do I have left after everything was taken care of, and then I took that lump sum of money and I told Sierra, so what do you want to do? Anything in the world, what do you want to do? And she would say, buy toys, or I want to do this, or I want to do that, whatever she thinks she wants to do. And that went on for pretty much ever until recently, so I lost my job. She's 4 years old. You do the math, 2006 is now, it's 4. 4 years. But now that I don't have a job, she doesn't understand. She doesn't understand why mom can't go buy her that Barbie that she wants. She doesn't understand why mom can't go out and go make her off and go to the movies or go here or go there because mommy doesn't have a job right now. She doesn't understand that. So she's a very spoiled little girl and I'm trying to reverse that. It's so hard though because, she has, in her room she has a TV, a DVD player, a karaoke machine. She has PlayStation 2 in her room with the PlayStation games, and she has movies and everything that she wants. And here she comes. She has tons of Barbies, toys, stuffed animals like you wouldn't believe.
This is her draw.
Oh, did you draw her? Can we show it? Look, she just drew this picture.
It's a dress.
This is her dress right here. This is her dress. All right.
And then the
Go draw on the back. Go draw mommy a picture of something on the back.
And then I'll draw you too,
Okay.
and you,
Okay.
and me.
Okay. 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 So anyways, like I was saying, she has everything that she wants. She has, multiple pairs of shoes. Okay. Okay. She has shoes, she has toys, she has everything, and I asked her today. I asked her. I said, "Do you like your stuff? Do you think mommy treats you good by toys and your different gadgets that you have?" And in my room, I have this little piece of crap TV, and Sierra has a good one in her room. She has a nice TV in her room, but yeah, I'm trying to. I don't know how to reverse that. I need to either just get a job and continue spoiling her, or I'm gonna get a job regardless. But I wanna save money because I'm gonna take her to SeaWorld. I've gonna say that in a couple of my videos, but it's gonna be hard because if Sierra says I want this and I got the money and she's really fit, I'm gonna get it for her. So I don't know how that's gonna work out. On the other hand, no means no, and she needs to learn the word no. Her dad doesn't tell her no. She goes to her dad every weekend, and she can do new crap, and it drives me crazy, because I'm like, I'm trying to teach her that money doesn't grow on trees, and she can't have whatever she wants when she wants it, because she has been throwing fit lately about, I want to go, I want this movie, and I tell her, well, when I have money, I will buy it for you, but I don't have money right now. just like, I don't care. And I'm just like, shut up, I can't fight. Yeah. So she's very spoiled. I don't know what to do about it. I think it's like my fault that I've already been at one job for a really long time, like a couple of years, and it didn't turn out that way. So, you know, I'm trying to get into this other job and getting a job, and I'm trying to get the daycare job. If I could do both, that'd be cool, because then, you know, I'll be able to pay my bills and I'll be able to, you know, have the things that I want too, like a digital video camera. Things like that. My cats, you know, would have the food that they want, so the food that they have to have. And the dog would be eating the food that he wants, so the food that he has to have for right now. You know, I just need to, I mean, I'm out there. I'm putting that. I'm doing what I gotta do. I'm out there. But it's just like, it's hard because the economy is bad, and I don't have a PPD like my school diploma. So that counts against me as that credit, which counts against me, and so you know what I'm saying? It's like, what do I do? Like, I'm trying so hard, and it's like, I'm running in place. Running in place. And I wake up every morning, like, oh gosh, so this video girl, I don't even want to do it. I didn't want to wake up today. Because of the depression of not having a job and not having money and knowing that, you know, all the bills are just right around the corner, what am I going to do about it? And, you know, calling my dad. It's just a bad situation right now, and I hate being so damn frustrated. And I hate just wanting things in my life and not getting them. So, yes, sir. Baby. Wait a minute. When I'm done, I will do it. I will call you.
It's hard.
Yeah, now go and I'll call you in a minute. Okay, so.
That's about it. I don't know what else to say. Except when my team will depress me, you know.
Especially here in Arizona, where it's 1,000 degrees outside at all times, and the sun's coming up even earlier, 5 o'clock in the morning, the sun's coming up, it's ridiculous, I hate it. Woo! So, anyways, that's what I wanted to talk about today. I hope you guys enjoyed it.